A particularly controversial California Democrat has tweeted some choice words at Elon Musk, some profanity, and dragged Tesla shortly after it was announced that Elon would be suing Alameda County for refusing to allow the Tesla plant to reopen. Elon Musk has been going on a tirade recently, arguing these lockdowns are unconstitutional and it's time to liberate or free America. He made the point that if you're not making stuff, then there's no stuff. It's a point I've also made. Recently, Gavin Newsom, the governor of California, announced they would begin the first phase in reopening the economy, which includes manufacturing plants. Elon Musk and Tesla then sent out a message that they would try to get their factory to around 30%. They did say to employees, if you don't feel safe, you don't have to come and work. But Alameda County said, we are not giving Elon Musk the green light, triggering an angry response from Elon, saying this is the last straw. That he was going to be filing a lawsuit and that he would actually relocate Tesla out of California. Now, look, this is really bad news for California, man. They're facing a $54 billion budget deficit. They're looking at an early fire season and a drought in the north. The last thing they need is to lose 10,000 jobs amid this crisis. They really need the money. What's funny about this California Democrat who tweeted these rather choice words about Elon is that she was the person responsible for something called Assembly Bill 5, which cost the state thousands or even tens of thousands of jobs, maybe even more. Assembly Bill 5 targeted the gig economy, and it resulted in basically every single freelance writer in the state, be it a journalist or maybe someone who was doing transcriptions or translations, they all lost their jobs. Companies like Vox started cutting off all of the contractors they had in California. And many progressives were dragging this woman. I find her statement and her response to Elon Musk kind of humorous, considering she has a really, really bad track record when it comes to jobs in California. And now her response amid news that Elon might actually take 10 to 30,000 jobs out of the state is to just say F you? Man, not a good time. Now, it's fair to point out the city in which I believe it's Fremont. A local politician is defending Elon Musk. And I gotta say, if the governor has said you can reopen, I think it's silly that Alameda County is gonna block him. So he is filing a lawsuit. But let's see exactly what's going on. And we'll start with the choice words of this California Democrat. Man, they look, you really gotta help the economy right now. Things are really bad. This is not the kind of message you wanna be sending out. But this woman, her name is Lorena Gonzales. She pushed AB 5. She is just awful when it comes to jobs. Okay, I know I said it. Let's read the news. Before we get started, head over to timcast.com/donate if you'd like to support my work. There are many ways that you can give if you want to help out, but the best thing you can do is just share this video. I'm competing against mainstream media who have nearly unlimited resources, and to make it worse, YouTube props them up in the algorithm. I don't have that advantage, but what I do have is your willingness to share. So if you really want to help the channel, it's the most powerful thing you can do. But if you just want to watch, hit the subscribe button, the like button, the notification bell, and hopefully that's enough to get YouTube to actually recommend my videos. But let's read the first story from the Daily Mail. California Democrat says, F Elon Musk after Tesla founder tweets company HQ will move to Texas or Nevada immediately. After California County health official says factory can't reopen despite Governor Gavin Newsom giving it green light. They say Gonzales' statement drew both praise and condemnation, particularly from people who pointed out the number of job losses if the Tesla factory moves. Tesla's Fremont factory employs 10,000 people. Not going to be good for the local economy, for the state economy. Not a smart thing to do to take this guy. Dan Crenshaw responded to the news that he would move to Texas. Texas gets better every day. Good conservative principles make good governance and attract the best and brightest. The future is happening in Texas. Talk about a very professional and epic response. Not even saying anything about Elon, but kind of saying something about Elon. Big Dan Rotimer from Nevada says Nevada needs these jobs most of all right now. Elon Musk, we would love to have you and Tesla HQ right here in the battle-born state. Jobs are important. Think about what happened in New York City with the Amazon deal. Now, as much as Ocasio-Cortez says she had nothing to do with them pulling out, she did. She was leading these protests. Democrats don't have a great record when it comes to jobs. I'm not going to pretend like Republicans are perfect, but come on, man. The news of the past several months has not been good. Unemployment is skyrocketing. I can only imagine people in this county are probably freaking out saying, stop, what are you doing? The people who work at the Tesla plant are probably freaking out too. They say, unlike Gonzales, Texas and Nevada Republicans were quick to embrace Musk's plans. Texas gets better every day. We read that one already, so I'll move on from here. But let's get to the big, big news. Tesla sues Alameda County to force California factory reopening. It's a bold move, Elon. We'll see how it plays out. But I thought you were going to move. Suppose I suppose it's possible Elon still relocates, but for the time being, he is suing. TechCrunch reports Tesla filed a lawsuit Saturday against Alameda County in an effort to invalidate orders that have prevented the automaker from reopening its factory in Fremont, California. The lawsuit, which seeks injunctive and declaratory relief against Alameda County, was first reported by CNBC. The lawsuit was filed in U.S. District Court for California's Northern District. Earlier Saturday, Tesla CEO Elon Musk tweeted that he was filing a lawsuit against Alameda County and threatened to move its headquarters and future programs to Texas or Nevada. Tesla had planned to bring back about 30% of its factory workers Friday as part of its reopening plan. Defying Alameda County's stay-at-home order, Musk was basing the reopening on new guidance issued Thursday by California Governor Gavin Newsom. So this we all know. The lawsuit argues that by preventing Tesla from opening, the Alameda County is going against its own guidance. Quote, Alameda County has expressly recognized and publicized that businesses may operate to manufacture batteries and electrical vehicles, the complaint reads. Inexplicably, however, the third order, as well as county officials, have simultaneously insisted that Tesla must remain shuttered, thereby further compounding the ambiguity, confusion, and irrationality surrounding Alameda County's position as to whether Tesla may resume manufacturing activities at its Fremont factory and elsewhere in the county. The term third order is a reference to a revised stay-in-place order issued by Alameda County. On Friday, the Alameda County Health Department said Tesla had not been given the green light to reopen and said if the company did, it would be out of compliance with the order. Now, here's what's really, really funny about this. Seems like according to this lawsuit, Elon Musk and Tesla are just saying you've issued wishy-washy statements. Can we open or not? Why are you saying we can't when you've previously said we could? So to see this response from Lorena Gomez, I find absolutely astounding. Is this really the appropriate way to handle Elon Musk's complaints? Now, well, here's what she said. First, she tweeted straight up, F Elon Musk, bravo. And she went on to say, California has highly subsidized a company that has always disregarded worker safety and well-being, has engaged in union busting and bullies public servants. I probably could have expressed my frustration in a less aggressive way. Of course, no one would have cared if I tweeted that. Why would anyone care why would they care? They care because you said something profoundly distasteful that doesn't help the situation, but actually makes it work. You then go on to drag the company. Let me ask the people of Fremont, do you agree with her assessment? Honestly, I don't know, but I'm willing to bet that at a time when things are getting particularly bad, you don't want to be losing 10,000 jobs. I mean, protests have been erupting across the country. Lockdown orders are being defied across the board. What makes you think this is the appropriate way to handle things? The only reason that Tesla's plant is remaining locked down is because they're agreeing to play by the rules. Meanwhile, across the country, tons of other companies aren't. Check out this story. 3,000 California churches plan to reopen in defiance of Governor Newsom's orders. Daily Caller reports, California Church United Pastors, which represents nearly 2.5 million members, announced Thursday that they plan to reopen May 31st instead of waiting for stage three reopenings, which includes churches along with businesses like salons and gyms, according to Fox. Now, I'm not here to say whether what they're doing is right or wrong, but to point out the difficult position that Elon Musk is in because he's a high profile and large company. If he was a small business, as we've seen, some of these small businesses have been fined, their owners have been arrested. But you could pull something like this off and maybe get a fine. But because Tesla's so massive, he has to play by the rules and it's very difficult for him to move, which gives him all the more reason to take those jobs away from California at a time when they're facing a major and very, very bad budget shortfall. $54 billion. You know what, man? I rag on California all the time. What is wrong with this state? I'll tell you what's wrong with it. It's people like Lorena Gonzales. Assemblywoman Lorena Gonzales shouts profanity at AB5 protester. It's not just her controversial state bill that the Assemblywoman has had to defend this week. This is a story from February 25th. This lady has taken thousands, tens of thousands of jobs away from California. And now in a state of frustration, Elon Musk might actually pull out more jobs. The last thing you want to do is agitate the guy. You want to apologize and say, please don't move your company. California, you can do business here. They need the money. But you can always count on someone like Lorena Gonzales, who has made enemies of the progressive left with this bill. You can always rest assured you'll get someone like her to fan the flames and make everything worse. She has done it in the past. Think about this story. Let me tell you about AB5. You had people who had weekend gigs writing articles. Maybe it was about a travel location. Because of this bill, which stated that gig workers could only do so much work for a company unless they were full-time employees. It included a special provision for a limit on how many articles a writer could write for a company. People lost their jobs. Vox's SB Nation, I believe it was, Vox's parent company, ended up severing several contracts. I mean, thousands of contracts, I believe, because they said, we can't hire you anymore. Thank this woman who led the charge, and she did it. Because unions pressured her to do it. And in response to this, when someone who's not a billionaire, who's just a protester, shouts at her saying, you know, basically they're mad because they took her job away, she just shouts profanity at them. Excellent, California. You can see why this place is run so horribly, right? In this story from CBS 8, they said, California Assemblywoman Lorena Gonzales of San Diego is under fire after video captured the moment she shouted a profanity at AB5 protesters who were demonstrating against her controversial gig economy law. But it's not just her controversial state bill. In this video, she can be heard saying F Donald Trump in the middle of an Elizabeth, Gonzales can be heard saying F Donald Trump in the middle of an Elizabeth Warren event in San Diego. Gonzales told News 8 she was repeating what she heard someone else shout because she agreed with the sentiment. Even though the event was for presidential candidate Warren, okay, quote, how illiterate can you be to not see signs that say AB5 and then yell F Trump, said Gloria Rivera. Rivera is a translator and interpreter, successfully operating as an independent contractor until she said AB5 began discouraging potential employers. They are not willing to risk it when you are a translator. You don't need someone specifically in California. So they get into the nitty gritty, basically, of what happened. I don't care about what this one woman is doing. I think the bigger issue is whether or not these laws, these bills are constitutional and how things are going to play out. Elon Musk tweeted about this saying, I'm not messing around. Absurd and medically irrational behavior in violation of constitutional civil liberties, moreover by unelected county officials with no accountability, needs to stop. And we can see this is from Third Row Tesla podcast, Tesla versus Alameda County, California, complaint for injunctive and declaratory relief. This is not just about Tesla. This is about every protester. It's about every job, every company, and everybody who wants things to reopen. Elon Musk is a high-profile individual who's essentially leading a major charge in getting these companies functioning again. We saw a woman in Texas get arrested for opening her business. You can't just print money and think that makes things all better. Because like Elon and many other people have said, if you're not making stuff, then there is no stuff. Now, what do you think the response from many people on, say, the left would be? Well, of course, Elon Musk has been championing freedom and opening these restrictions. And over at the r/politics subreddit, which is supposed to be a large network of 6 million individuals discussing politics, it's just leftist propaganda. And for some reason, the left is absolutely ignoring the real crisis we're facing in terms of the economic downturn. Don't tell me, I can't tell you why, man, other than tribal reasons, orange man bad, therefore no matter what he says, it's wrong. But the UN has warned of starvation, and you know it. There's another agency in the US saying 1 in 4 may go hungry. We got to get things churning again. Otherwise, we are going to see a much worse loss of life. Depression, anxiety, homelessness, medical issues. We can't just stop the machine. At a certain point, it's time to get it going again. But of course, here's what we get from the comments from the supposedly political discussion. I'm not going to read them for the most part. But typically, what you'll see if you go on Reddit, all the front page, you can tell it's total BS, by the way, total biased propaganda. People are claiming that Elon Musk is risking the lives of poor people because he just wants to make a profit. And this is the weirdest narrative I've seen in a long time, or one of the weirdest narratives I've ever seen. It's the people who want to work. I mean, people are protesting around the world. 3,000 churches are opening up. They're not doing this because they decided they need to put people at risk. It's 3,000 churches. It's the people who work at the churches. Yes, they're at risk too. But why do we keep seeing this propagandistic, whatever word, narrative? The narrative from the left, just like, oh no, the poor people, oh no, these big industrialists, they're gonna risk our lives. Elon Musk specifically said, you don't have to come back to work. Specifically stated. Well, let's read this. It says, getting back to work. This is an official statement from Tesla. They say, Tesla is the latest major car maker. Tesla is the last major car maker remaining in California and the largest manufacturing employer in the state, with more than 10,000 employees at our Fremont factory and 20,000 statewide. We understand the impacts of COVID-19 has caused and have a responsibility to look out for the livelihoods and safety of our personnel, many of whom rely on us and have been out of work for weeks due to the impacts of shelter-in-place orders. Given the governor's recent guidance, which is supported by science and credible health data, the state and federal government's classification of vehicle manufacturing as national critical infrastructure, and our robust safety plan, Tesla has started the process of resuming operations. Our employees are excited to get back to work, and we're doing so with their health and safety in mind. They say, our restart plan is the result of months of careful planning and preparation. It was modeled after the comprehensive return to work plan we established at our Shanghai Gigafactory, which has seen smooth and healthy operations for the past 3 months. We're taking the time we need to get our personnel properly trained before they begin to work, and all employees must complete an online video training before returning to work at any Tesla facility. We have a thorough return to work plan for all locations. A cross-functional response team, including an in-house physician, has been working daily to establish health and safety guidelines based on location and job-specific risk assessments. And we're continuously reviewing our processes to ensure they work for our employees in this new environment. Back in March, we conducted risk assessments at each site, looking at how and where people work, how they interact, and what measures are needed to meet safety standards. In some cases, we have added partitions or barriers to separate work areas and minimized employee interactions by positioning parts closer to where that task is completed or the line. We are also requiring additional personal protective equipment, along with rigorous cleaning and disinfecting protocols. Our return to work playbook details the comprehensive safety measures we have introduced to ensure employee safety. I am not just going to read their statement and claim they're being honest. If somebody doesn't want to work, you don't have to work. That's the most important thing. But I think what we can really see from the responses on Reddit and from the statement from this California Democrat, Lorena Gonzales, F Elon Musk. They don't know. They don't care. They didn't read the plan. They didn't read the statement. They just want it to shut down. And I can't tell you why other than tribal reasons. Of course, there are some conspiracy theories that the Democrats are hoping the lockdown will persist so it hurts Donald Trump. I'm sure there are some people who think so. And maybe that's the guiding narrative of the tribalist left's position. Willful ignorance, a refusal to actually read what their plan is and look at their safety protocols, and then claim they're sacrificing the poor people. Elon Musk wants to reopen. That's fine. They recently lost a bunch of money because Elon tends to be a eccentric billionaire type individual tweeting out things on Twitter, making people quite upset. But it's so strange to see, you know, Reddit used to love Elon Musk, and now it's just become fringe partisan propaganda. And I rag on Reddit quite a bit, but you know, I'll throw some more shade in there. There's a subreddit called Pics, P-I-C-S, pictures. And the other day, someone posted some weird meme about Trump. And I'm like, why is this in a picture subreddit? Why are you putting politics in meme subreddits? Makes no sense. Why are the only comments we see blind ignorance? Let me tell you something. To the lady saying F Elon Musk, to the lady saying, to the people saying Elon Musk doesn't care about the poor people, here's a statement from Mayor Lily May on Tesla. She said, as the local shelter-in-place order continues without provisions for major manufacturing activities such as Tesla, to resume, I am growing concerned about the potential implications for our regional economy. We know many essential businesses have proven they can successfully operate using strict safety and social distancing practices. I strongly believe these same practices could be possible for other manufacturing businesses, especially those that are so critical to our employment base. The city encourages the county to engage with our local businesses to come up with acceptable guidelines for reopening our local economy. As we have done for over a decade, the city is prepared to support Tesla as soon as they are able to resume automobile manufacturing operations and are committed to a thoughtful, balanced approach to this effort that remains safe for our Fremont community. So now think about all the people dragging Elon Musk, who is being actively supported by the mayor of Fremont, who is being cussed at by someone from San Diego, not even Fremont. Why? Why are you so angry about all of this? Protesters are showing up saying we want our jobs back. And what do? They mock and belittle them in the press and insult them and call them rednecks who want haircuts. These are people who are on the record saying, I need to work. I need to eat. The Dallas salon owner, she said, I have kids who need to eat. And I have employees who are not eating because they're feeding their kids instead. So she says, I won't apologize. I'm reopening. So what do? They lock her in jail. Think about what's going on. In Dallas, they released prisoners, hardened criminals, saying, we don't want people to get sick, but you're a salon owner. We're going to lock you up for 7 days. It was a county jail where they released these people. How does any of this make sense? So you can drag Elon Musk, but I'll tell you what, when you do not look like a good faith actor. And this is the big problem I have with, you know, left, right, culture war, whatever. And it's why I find myself where I am. Where is the honest left saying if Elon Musk wants to safely reopen and it's in the best interest of the region, the governor agrees, the mayor agrees, then perhaps Alameda County is wrong and he is justified in filing this lawsuit. Why then would some other Democrat from nowhere just say, F you? It's an emotional response. It argues nothing. These people have something beyond Trump derangement syndrome. It's look, Trump derangement syndrome. People just get irrationally angry at whatever it is Trump does. But now it's infecting the periphery to anything around what may be in line with what Donald Trump is saying. So if Trump comes out and says that we need to reopen things and liberate, anybody now who goes anywhere near giving someone a job must be in line with Trump, or not even that. They just, the same twisted anger and hate they feel towards Trump, they now assign to literally anyone who goes against the tribe. That's how bad it's getting. So let me remind you all, the people dragging Elon Musk and saying F you, the mayor is trying to support Elon to reopen. Isn't that good enough? Shouldn't you back off because you don't know what Fremont needs? You want to argue about New York and how they're doing? Go for it. New York being the epicenter can do what New York needs. Fremont needs something else. So you know what, man? I don't know if Elon Musk will actually leave, but outside of the nitty gritty of this circumstance, I think to a lot of conservatives, Elon Musk is a standard bearer. He's rushing full speed into this fight, waving that flag. And it's many conservatives who want to see things reopened, who want their jobs back and don't want to sit around and don't want to take a handout. There's another really strange thing about what we see on Reddit and other comment forums. The left arguing, why don't these rednecks just take universal basic income? Has it ever occurred to you that they don't want to take money from the government, that they want to just work and produce things and be free to live how they see fit? This is what these people in these cities don't understand. I don't understand why you wouldn't want to just sit around in your apartment and collect a check from the government. A lot of people don't want to do that. I have the privilege of doing some kind of media job where I get to express myself in a way that is fulfilling every day. And I imagine a lot of people are having an existential crisis as they can no longer perform their much needed task. People love doing their jobs. Not everybody. I guess maybe if you live in a big city and you work at a really awful office job, you're probably not happy. But a lot of people, and I think I understand why it's conservatives, do work that makes them happy, be it a trade job, working at a salon, being a barber, or working in a factory. They like building things. They want to get back to work. They want to make money for themselves. And you are standing in their way because in your city, in New York, for some reason, you think what applies there applies to Fremont, California. So you know what, man? I'm not going to tell Elon Musk what he needs to do. If he wants to open the plant and his employees want to come back, it's their choice. Why are all these people acting like Elon Musk is sacrificing these people when these people of their own volition will go back to work? because they want authoritarianism. Because the people are too stupid? I don't know. You tell me. I'll leave it there. Stick around. Next segment's coming up at youtube.com/timcastnews at 6 p.m. And I will see you all then.